Good morning, dear saints. It's good to be with you again today. Pastor Mercer here. It's Tuesday in our fifth week of Lent. Our psalm for today is Psalm 39, verses 1 through 7. We continue now with the Passion readings in Mark as we go. This is now Jesus before the council and Peter denying Jesus. Our Lenten catechesis, we continue with the keys. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. In the morning, O Lord, you hear my voice. In the morning I prepare a sacrifice for you and watch. My mouth is filled with your praise and with your glory all the day. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Psalm 39, 1 through 7. I said, I will guard my ways that I may not sin with my tongue. I will guard my mouth with a muzzle so long as the wicked are in my presence. I was mute and silent. I held my peace to no avail, and my distress grew worse. My heart became hot within me. As I mused, the fire burned. Then I spoke with my tongue. O Lord, make me know my end and what is the measure of my days. Let me know how fleeting I am. Behold, you have made my days a few handbreadths, and my lifetime is as nothing before you. Surely all mankind stands as a mere breath. Surely a man goes about as a shadow. Surely for nothing they are in turmoil. Man heaps up wealth and does not know who will gather. And now, O Lord, for what do I wait? My hope is in you. We go to Mark chapter 14, verse 53. And they led Jesus to the high priest, and all the chief priests and the elders and the scribes came together. And Peter had followed him at a distance right into the courtyard of the high priest. And he was sitting with the guards and warming himself at the fire. Now the chief priests and the whole council were seeking testimony against Jesus to put him to death, but they found none. For many bore false witness against him, but their testimony did not agree. And some stood up and bore false witness against him, saying, We heard him say, I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and in 3 days I will build another not made with hands. Yet even about this their testimony did not agree. And the high priest stood up in the midst and asked Jesus, Have you no answer to make? What is it that these men testify against you? But he remained silent and made no answer. Again the high priest asked him, Are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed? And Jesus said, I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power and coming with the clouds of heaven. And the high priest tore his garments and said, What further witnesses do we need? You have heard his blasphemy. What is your decision? And they all condemned him as deserving death. And some began to spit on him and to cover his face and to strike him, saying to him, Prophesy. And the guards received him with blows. And as Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the servant girls of the high priest came, and seeing Peter warming himself, she looked at him and said, You also were with the Nazarene Jesus. But he denied it, saying, I neither know nor understand what you mean. And he went out into the gateway, and the rooster crowed. And the servant girl saw him and began to say to the bystanders, This man is one of them. But again he denied it. And after a little while, the bystanders again said to Peter, Certainly you are one of them, for you are a Galilean. But he began to invoke a curse on himself and to swear, I do not know this man of whom you speak. And immediately the rooster crowed a second time. And Peter remembered how Jesus had said to him, Before the rooster crows twice, you will deny me 3 times. And he broke down and wept. This is the word of the Lord. Jesus brought before the council, Jesus being accused of blasphemy. The ones who are accusing him of blasphemy are blaspheming themselves. As the high priest stood up and asked him if he was the Christ, the Son of the Blessed, and Jesus said, "I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power, coming with the clouds of heaven." "You have heard this blasphemy," they speak. "What is your decision?" And he was condemned to death. As we walk through these passion readings, dear saints, this week, we are constantly reminded again of what our Lord suffered, what he took on himself for you and for me. And then we see here that it's that Peter standing back, not wanting to be seen, acting like a coward, and he doesn't want to be caught, that he knows Jesus, and so he tries to blend in with everybody else out there in the courtyard. It didn't work out so well for him, and three times then he denies Jesus, and after the cock crows the second time, he realizes what Jesus had said to him, and he goes out and he weeps bitterly. I guess when we look at this, oftentimes I look at Peter and I think, how many times have we struggled with this sin where we've denied Jesus, where because we've been in some kind of situation or something, we don't want to speak up in some way, we deny that we have faith, being a Christian, all those kind of things. And yet, when we look at this, our Lord never denies us. He never turns us away. When you and I have struggled with faith, when we are unfaithful, yet he cares for us, and he never turns his face away from us, because you, as a baptized child of God, you belong to him. And this is great comfort for us, dear saints, because this is the gospel for us. This is the gospel good news, that this same Jesus that we're reading, that's now before the council, that is about to suffer and die, he does this for you and for me, for all of our sins, the sins of denial, the sins of faith, weak faith, the sins of every time we sin, we break one of the Ten Commandments. This one, he was the perfect one. He was sinless. He went and sacrificed himself for you and for me. Well, I know that you that are listening today feel this way, but I got to tell you, I'm really glad that he did that for me. I'm really glad that this is the Jesus who died for me. I'm glad that he died for you too, but when I look at myself, dear saints, I know the sinner that I am, and I know, and I am glad, I am joyful that Christ suffered and died for me. He is my Savior, and I will forever thank him for saving me from my sin. There's a prayer of the day in here that I think is fitting once again. I like to read these prayers, and I'm going to pray this prayer here. Lord Jesus Christ, the temple of your body was destroyed on the cross and 3 days later raised from the dead and exalted to the right hand of the Father. Visit us now with this same body that we may not deny that we know you, but in faith hear in our ears your life-giving voice and receive on our lips your very body and blood to strengthen us in times of temptation. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. What a great prayer for us when coming to the sacrament, the Holy Supper, that is Jesus there, in with and under, the bread and wine for you and for me. That is Jesus, again, strengthening your faith, giving you nourishment for your soul. Dear saints, word and sacrament, this is Jesus. This is the risen Savior for you and for me. In our Lenten catechesis, we continue with the keys. This is from Small Card Articles 3 and 4, and it says this: "We will now return to the gospel, which does not give us counsel and aid against sin in only one way. God is superabundantly generous in his grace, first through the spoken word, by which the forgiveness of sins is preached in the whole world. This is the particular office of the gospel. Second, through baptism. Third, through the holy sacrament of the altar. Fourth, through the power of the keys. Also, through the mutual conversation and consolation of brethren, where two or three are gathered, and other such verses." That is from, again, that's from Small Called 3 and 4. We pray. We pray the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I thank you, my heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have kept me this night from all harm and danger. And I pray that you would keep me this day also from sin and every evil, that all my doings in life may please you. For into your hands I commend myself, my body and soul, and all things. Let your holy angel be with me, that the evil foe may have no power over me. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Dear saints, look to the one who has saved you from your sins. Keep your head held high this week as we are walking through this last week of Lent together. We can rejoice. We can rejoice that as we look at our sin and the gravity of our sin, that we have the Savior, the promised Savior, who came and died and suffered for us, for you and for me. This is wonderful gospel good news for us as we now, through this last week of Lent, and we are going to into the Holy Week. This is a great time, good time to continue to pause and reflect on our sin, but that we give thanks to God that he has saved us from sin, death, and the devil. Have a great day, and I'll see you again tomorrow.